Most Americans are repelled by the mere notion of homosexuality. The CBS News survey shows that 2 out of 3 Americans look upon homosexuals with disgust, discomfort, or fear. 1 out of 10 says hatred.
Your mom wanting you to go to therapy, was that due to like homosexuality, or was that just because of everything?
Yeah, because before then, when I first came out to my mom, she came from like Asia, like the 80s and everything, where they just like rejected things that are different, and she was like taught like homosexuality was like a very bad thing.
Right.
She's not religious, but like the way she was taught was yeah. religious like. So, the way she was taught, homosexuality was basically a disease to her. So, like, she thought I was sick, so she took me to, like, a therapist to, like, seek treatment. Like, after, like, a session with, like, just my mom and me, like, she, like, realized that, like, homosexuality is, like, a natural thing.
Yeah.
So it's not, like, treatable in a way where you just take a medication and it'll go away.
Right.
And, yeah.
These groups, they're called the ex-gay groups, mm-hmm. they don't accept the idea of a genetic or biological reason for homosexuality. The camp works with two different fronts. First, there's addressing the emotional wounds that they believe lead to homosexuality. And the second is addressing each man's physical needs for touch and comfort and affection. From what I could tell, most of the men there were there voluntarily. Everyone was 18.
Tonight, Jason Jones takes us on a journey to the front lines of modern medicine.
Medical science. It's both medical and science.
Yet there are some things even it can't cure. Welcome to The Daily Show's newest segment, Diagnosis Mystery. Growing up, Wayne Besson was your average all-American kid when his life became a nightmare.
All my friends were looking at all the cheerleaders and couldn't get enough of them. And I was looking at the other guys on the basketball team.
But his symptoms didn't go away. When the tests came back, they confirmed his worst fear.
Your friend could be gay.
That's right, gay. The big G. It strikes millions of Americans each year. Desperate for a cure, Wayne and his family tried everything.
This is a tape my parents bought me when they tried to make me straight.
All right, let's give her a listen.
This program is designed to reorient your sexuality.
Just go online and start looking for them, and you find the websites, and you see that Exodus International, which is the biggest umbrella group for these ex-gay programs, and they have ministries all over the country, and they have quite a few in other parts of the world. Yeah, Exodus is evangelical Christian. There's also Evergreen International, which is for Mormons. There's a group called Jonah for Jews who are seeking to become straight.
Overwhelming scientific evidence demonstrates that conversion therapy, especially when it's practiced on young people, is neither medically nor ethically appropriate and can cause substantial harm. Now, recently, the White House has taken certain steps to try to increase equality for people who are transgendered, who are lesbian and gay, bisexual. And they've made it very public, things that they want to do within the federal government, for federal contractors. But to ban this therapy nationwide would require Congress. So what they did in the response to this petition was to say, we support states who take these steps. And some states have banned conversion therapy, including California, New Jersey, and D.C.
When a woman is pregnant with a boy, scientists are realizing that her female body often sees the male fetus as a foreign object and begins to produce antibodies against it. The more boys a woman has, the more adept her body becomes at feminizing the fetus, which may explain why with every successive boy, the odds that he will be gay go up significantly.
All right, maybe you all accept it, but what about those people who started out gay and say they became straight by discovering God? What about ex-gay ministries?
Even so-called ex-gay ministries don't claim to change a person's inner sexual desires. Just his or her sexual conduct.
We're still gay.
If these places really work, why don't they all use the same technique? Why does each ministry experiment its own way?
Well...
And why have so many members and leaders recanted earlier claims that they were changed?
Maybe these programs don't work for everyone, but what's the harm?
How about the feelings of shame and guilt they instill and reinforce in their victims? Or the money, energy, and time they sap from people who have nothing wrong with them.
Says you.
Well, in point of fact, not just George says that, Christian. The American Medical Association, the American Psychiatric Association, the American Psychological Association, the American Psychoanalytic Association, the American Academy of Pediatrics, and the National Association of Social Workers have all stated that homosexuality should not be treated as a mental disorder, and that they oppose attempts at reparative or conversion therapy, and that sexual orientation is not a choice and cannot be changed.
Try to make me go to rehab, I said no.